Hi, this is Julieta Yang Orfiano. Welcome to my video. Kung first time ka sa channel ko, please like, share, at mag-subscribe ka para ma-notify kita kapag may bago akong video. Sa videong ito, ang pag-uusapan natin ay tungkol sa organization and formation of a corporation. Ang mga topics na tatalakayin ko ay ang sumusunod. First, definition of a corporation. Second, characteristic of a corporation. Third, advantages of a corporation. Fourth, disadvantages of a corporation. Fifth, classes of corporation. Sixth, components of a corporation. Seventh, organizing a corporation. Eighth, articles of incorporation. Nine, bylaws. 10, corporate records. 11, share capital or capital stock. Definition of a corporation. A corporation is an artificial being created by operation of law, having the rights of succession and the powers, attributes, and properties expressly authorized by law or incident to its existence. Section 1, Corporation Code of the Philippines. Characteristics of a corporation. First, separate legal entity, artificial being. A corporation is an artificial being with personality that is separate from that of its individual owners. Thus, it may under its corporate name take hold or convey property to the extent allowed by law, enter into contracts, and sue or be sued. Second, created by operation of law. A corporation is generally created by operation of law. The merge agreement of the parties cannot give rise to a corporation. Third, right of succession. A corporation has the right of succession irrespective of the death, withdrawal, insolvent, or incapacity of the individual member or shareholders, and regardless of the transfer of their interest or share capital, a corporation can continue its existence up to the period of time stated in the articles of incorporation, but not exceeding 50 years. Number 4, powers, attributes, properties authorized by law. A corporation has only the powers, attributes, and properties expressly authorized by law or incident to its existence. Being a mere creation of law, a corporation can only exercise powers provided by law and those powers which are incidental to its existence. Number 5, ownership divided into shares. Proprietorship in a corporation is divided into units, known as share capital. The buyers of this share capital are called shareholder or stockholders and are considered owners of the business. Number 6, board of directors. Management of the business is vested in a board of directors elected by the shareholders. The Board of Directors is governing body or decision-making body of the corporation. The corporation law provides that the number of directors be not less than 5 but not more than 15. Advantages of a corporation. First, the corporation's power of succession enables it to enjoy a continuous existence. Second, the continuity of corporate existence enables it to obtain a strong credit line. Third, large-scale business undertakings are made possible because many individuals can invest their funds in the enterprise. Number 4, the liability of each investor or shareholders is limited to the extent of their investment in the corporation. Number 5, the transfer of shares can be effected without the need for prior consent of other shareholders. Number 6, its smooth operation is guaranteed because of centralized management. Disadvantages of a corporation. First, it's not easy to organize because of complicated legal requirements and high costs in organization. Second, limited liability of its shareholders may weaken its credit capacity. Third, it is subject to rigid governmental control. Fourth, it is subject to more taxes. Fifth, its centralized management restricts a more active participation by shareholders in the conduct of corporate affairs. Classes of corporation. Corporations are generally classified according to purpose, membership, holdings, compliance of law, law of creation, extent of membership, or other basis of classification. Generally, profit-oriented corporations are open, private, and stock corporations. Non-profit corporations are public and private non-stock corporations. The following is a list of common classes of corporation. First, as to membership holdings, A, stock corporation, a private corporation in which the capital is divided into shares of stock and is authorized to distribute corporate earnings to holders on the basis of shares held. The owner of stock corporations are called stockholders or shareholders. Letter B, non-stock corporation, a private corporation in which capital comes from fees paid by individual composing it. The owner of non-stock corporation are called members. Second, as to purpose. A, public corporation. A public corporation is a corporation that is organized to govern a portion of state, for example, municipalities, provinces. B, private corporation. A private corporation is a corporation that is organized for a private benefit, aim, or end. Letter C, quasi-public corporation. A quasi-public corporation is a private corporation which is given a franchise to perform functions of a public character. Classified under this type are the so-called public utility corporation such as Meralco and PLDT. Number 3, as to compliance of law, A, de jure corporation. The jure corporation is a corporation which exists in both law and fact. It exists in law because it has complied with all the legal requirements. It exists in fact because it actually operates as a corporation. Letter B, de facto corporation. De facto corporation is a corporation which exists only in fact but not in law. It does not exist in law because of non-compliance with certain legal requirements. Number 4, as to law of creation. A, domestic corporation. A domestic corporation is a corporation that organized under Philippine law. Letter B, foreign corporation. A foreign corporation is a corporation that is organized under the law of other countries. Number 5, as to the extent of membership. A, open corporation. An open corporation is a corporation whose ownership is widely held by many investors, usually a private stock corporation. Letter B, closely held corporation or family corporation is a private corporation in which 50% or more of its stock is owned by 5 persons or less. Other types of corporations include parent or holding corporations, subsidiary corporations, ecclesiastical corporations, and lay corporations which are themselves classified into other groups. Components of a corporation. First, incorporators. Incorporators are the persons who originally formed the corporation and whose names appear in the articles of incorporation. They must be natural persons as distinguished from artificial persons. Second, corporators. Corporators are corporators of a stock corporations. Third, stockholders or shareholders. Stockholders or shareholders are the corporators of a stock corporation. Number four, members. Members are the corporators of a non-stock corporation. Number five, promoters. Promoters are the persons who undertake to A, form a company based on a given project, B, set it going, and C, take the necessary steps to accomplish the purpose for which the corporation is organized. Number six, subscribers. Subscribers are the persons who have agreed to take original and issued shares but will pay at a later date. They may be incorporators or not, and they may eventually become shareholders the moment the full payment of their subscription is made. Number seven, underwriter. Underwriter are those who undertake to dispose of the shares to the general public. Organizing a corporation. The process of organizing a corporation generally consists of three stages, which normally require the aid of legal, competent advisors. These three stages are discussed as follows. First, promotion. The incorporators make preliminary arrangements to set up a tentative working organization and to solicit subscriptions to raise sufficient capital for the business. Second, incorporation. The process of formalizing the organization of the corporation. These stages includes A, drafting of articles of incorporation which must be duly executed and acknowledged before a notary public. B, filing of the articles of incorporation with the Securities and Exchange Commission or SEC, together with a statement showing that at least 25% of the total authorized share capital, also known as authorized capital stock, has been subscribed, and that at least 25% of the total subscription have been paid. Letter C. After the required fee have been paid and upon approval of the articles of incorporation, the SEC issues a certificate of incorporation, the date of which being considered as the date of registration of incorporation. Third, commencement of business. The business should start its operation within 2 years from the date of incorporation. Failure to do so will automatically dissolve the corporation without the need for hearing. Costs incurred during incorporation, such filing fees, costs of printing stock certificates, promoters' commission, and legal fees are known as organization costs or pre-operating costs. Under PAS 38, intangible assets, organization or pre-operating costs are charged to expense in the period incurred. Articles of incorporation. The articles of incorporation enumerate the powers and limitations conferred upon the corporation by the government. It includes the following information. First, the name of the corporation. Second, the purpose or purposes for which the corporation is formed. Third, the place of the principal office of the corporation. Fourth, the term of existence of the corporation not exceeding 50 years. Fifth, the name, nationalities, and addresses of the incorporators. Sixth, the names of the directors who will serve until their successors are duly elected and qualified in accordance with the bylaws. Number 7, the authorized share capital or authorized capital stock. The classes of share capital or stocks to be issued and the number of shares and terms of each class indicating the par value per share if there is any. Number 8, the amount of subscription to the share capital or capital stock, the names of the subscribers and the name of share subscribed by each. And number 9, the total amount paid on the subscription to the share capital or capital stock and the amount paid by each subscribers on his subscription. Bylaws. The bylaws of the corporation supplement the articles of incorporation. It contains provisions for the internal administration of the corporation. The corporation bylaws normally include the following. First, the date, place, and manner of calling the annual shareholders or stockholders meeting. Second, the manner of conducting meeting. Third, the circumstances which may permit the calling of special meetings of the shareholders. Number 4, the manner of voting and the use of proxies. Number 5, the manner of electing the directors and the number of directors. Number 6, the term of office of the directors. Number 7, the authority and duties of the directors. Number 8, the manner of selecting the corporate officer. Number 9, the authority and responsibilities of the officers. Number 10, the procedure for amending the article of incorporations. And number 11, the procedure for amending the bylaws. Corporate records. The corporate generally maintains the following records to keep track of its various transactions. First, record of all business transactions. Journal, ledgers, vouchers, and other supporting documents. Second, minutes of all meetings of directors. Third, minutes of all meetings of shareholders or stockholders. Number 4, stock and transfer book. A, shareholders or stockholders journal, chronological and numerical record of stock certificates issued. Letter B, shareholders or stockholders ledger, alphabetical record of individual shareholders. Letter C, subscribers ledger, alphabetical record of individual subscribers. Number 5, optional and supplementary record. Share capital or capital stock. Share capital is also known as capital stock. It is the amount fixed by the corporate charter to be subscribed and paid in or secured, and paid in or secured to be paid in by the shareholders of the corporation, either in money or in property, labor, or services, upon the organization of the corporation, or afterwards and upon which it is to conduct its operations. Thank you for watching my video. I hope nagustuhan mo at may natutunan ka sa videong ito. Meron akong ginawang part 2 at continuation nito kung saan idiniscuss ko ang classes of share capital. I-click mo lang sa taas o sa link sa baba ng videong ito para mapanood mo yung part 2. Don't forget to like, share, at mag-subscribe ka sa channel ko. Once again, this is Julieta Yang Orfiano. See you on my next video.